astrology, any of this, what you call this, all this logic. Okay, they are in Greek or Latin. What is the reason behind why they are not in Hindi or English or this in French or Chinese? So hello guys, bit of late. I can't do in this, like this is uncontrollable factor. So how are you, everyone? Fine. इतने बच्चे थे कल, एक कम है शायद. एक लड़का भाग गया क्या? तबियत खराब हो गई बेचारे की. ऐसा क्या हो गया मेरी क्लास लेने के बाद ही तबियत खराब? तो मुझे तो फिर पढ़ानी नहीं चाहिए. दिस इज वेरी मॉरली रॉन्ग. वी शैल डिस्कस दिस, ऑल दिस मोरालिटी, एथिक्स, सोसाइटल एथिक्स, इंडिविजुअल एथिक्स, मोरालिटी, दिस ऑल दिस जार्गन्स वी विल स्टडी इन दिस होल चैप्टर. हाँ, आज उसकी छुट्टी ले ली उसने. कम ऑन, इट्स ओके. सो यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द सिलेबस. इट्स नॉट लाइक नॉट सिलेबस, इन फैक्ट the approach we will proceed in this whole preparation of ethics paper. Okay, that is GS4. Okay, today we have a new entrant. What is your name, ma'am? Iram. Okay, Iram. So welcome to our class. Okay, yesterday it's the beginning, but still we are on this, like abhi ne subject abhi khula hi nahi hai, hai na? So today I'll discuss what is ethics, how this is like interchangeably, many of the things used interchangeably, for example morality, ethics, same. Okay, value, ethics. Ethics is not religion, raw, and what is the scope of the ethics, and what is the definition of us all about ethics? What is the all about exactly? And again, also we'll see this syllabus also, because yesterday in class we have discussed the approach, how you proceed in this whole examination. Now today I'll discuss all these things. Okay, so first chapter we will study. How many units are there in syllabus? Also given you the task, you have to go through the syllabus. Syllabus should be inked in your mind, like this is inscribed something on this rock. पता नहीं इंस्क्रिप्शन होते थे रॉक्स पे खुदे हुए. तो थिंग शुड बी लाइक इंजीनियर मेमोरी. ओके, शुड बी क्लियर. यू हैव टू बी लाइक फोर एंड फॉरमोस्ट थिंग्स, पीवाईक्यू एंड सिलेबस. नाउ गाइस, सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद दिस. आई हैव गिविंग यू द ग्लिम्स ऑफ व्हाट कि जस्ट आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस इंडियन स्टेट और दिस मॉडर्न स्टेट वीवी व्हिच आवर फोर फादर इन फैक्ट दिस आर दिस पॉलिसी मेकर द आर्किटेक्ट ऑफ मॉडर्न इंडिया हैव फॉर्म्ड. What is this? A modern state that was democratic in nature, and the main function of this whole state, setting of the state, was two: welfare and law and order. Now we have this welfare aspect, which you have to run as an administrator. All this policy matter implementation, everything comes in your realm after selection in this examination. So you'll become this harbinger of welfareism in Indian economy. So you guys are the agent of change also. Okay, change is sometimes a very status quo thing. Nobody's want to change. You want to change? If I'll say you change your routine, daily routines, like no, I can't get up. Okay, so please, I'm stick to my routine. So change is like a very, change is inevitable. Any society which doesn't change, they are becomes obsolete over the period of time. So change is like we have to adapt to this technological changes, we have to adopt to this societal changes that is going on, in fact. And in the society, there's a famous term, cultural lag. When the societal aspect, this value and the norms of the society doesn't match with this change in this technological changes in the society or the technological upgradation, this lags is called cultural lag. I'm giving you another dimension of it. So this is nothing related to ethics, but everything related to ethics, because you have to do all sort of bayanbazi in this paper. So I'll make you learn all those. Okay, so this is now what. So first unit, ethics and human interface. Okay, such like an interface, wave interface, you have seen. Interface is what? Interface, if I take the example of interface, many of this, like for example window is like an interface. You have a system, hardware or this computer setting to work on this computer, to work on this, to get, for example, you have to work on this, you have to prepare a attendance sheet of the student. For that purpose, you have to use Excel. Okay, for this Excel, through this software medium, this is called interface. Human interface. So here, human means connection between two, and the connection between individual and the society. How this overall conversation happens? How this conversation or this platform is what? Human interface. This is all the dimension of ethics. You learn lots of things as a norms, the value, you have a liking, you have a preferences, Exactly. And this source of all this liking, preferences is what? Society. You'll learn lots of your worldview, what you have like exactly. If I go by this ideological level, your worldview, what you think about a particular thing, for example. Okay, this you have a source from society. And this is the process of socialization. Okay, from since the moment you born in our family, okay, from this stage, from play stage, from to game stage, you all are learning, in fact. This articulation, this symbols exactly, which you signify something. For example, if I say, it means something exactly. Nobody has applied this means in itself. Okay, this is means only this pranam. In any of the society, it could be considered bad. For example, if I say like this, this could be considered bad in many of this society. So this symbol, this assigning this value or assigning this meaning of this action, this is what? This is done by through what means? Norms, values, exactly, ethics. Everything is now muggled up. Ethics, value, everything. Sir, aapne toh pehle sab mug up kar diya apne ko. Okay, so this is what? Human interface. So ethics and human interest, this is the starting of the chapter. So before going to this, what is ethics all about? Let me discuss what are the syllabus we have. Exactly. So what are the syllabus we have? You have a street syllabus, aapne padha aap logo ne. ये बताया था मैंने कल आपको यूपीएससी आपसे चाहता क्या है. दिस इज गिवन इन द नोटिफिकेशन इटसेल्फ. द फर्स्ट यूनिट इज एथिक्स एंड ह्यूमन इंटरफेस. इनफैक्ट दिस इज अ मैक्रो. इनफैक्ट दिस इज ऑल सब टॉपिक्स इन्वॉल्व्ड इन दिस. वी विल गो इनटू दिस, बट सी दिस मैक्रो. एसेंस, एसेंस, व्हाट इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द एथिक्स. डिटरमिनेंस, व्हाट आर थिंग्स विल डिटरमाइन दिस एथिक्स और द एथिकल बिहेवियर ऑफ पर्टिकुलर पर्सन. एग्जैक्टली कंसिक्वेंस ऑफ द एथिक्स इन द ह्यूमन एक्शन. What is the consequence? Why we follow this ethics? What could it lead to? The purpose, because we are following all this ethics, it should serve some purpose, na? Otherwise, doing anything without any purpose is what? Meaningless. There must be some purpose. So there's a purpose of this. What is this consequence of this human action? Why you incorporate this ethics? Or in this whole chapter, why you as a civil servant incorporate all these values or this ethical behavior which are supposed to act or do in an action in the working. Okay, so this is what now dimension of ethics. How many types of the ethics? We'll discuss this normative ethics, deontological ethics, many of the types of ethics. Okay, now ethics is a private and a public relation. How this ethics in a public and private, in fact, ethics, this realm of ethics has expanded that. Now you have many of this as medical ethics, bioethics. Getting my point? Every time corporate ethics. Every time, every organization, every setup, institution or social surrounding has an ethics which you have to follow. A certain norms or certain kind of action you need to have for that particular context. Otherwise, you'll become irrelevant. For example, here you are the student, you have certain ethics. Okay, if you come like you are not like compliant of this ethics, what will happen? I enter all circuses. This is what this, because it creates a system exactly. Ethics is what? This appropriate behavior which you are supposed to do exactly, which is something demand from you exactly. This is in concurrence of something. Okay, so it has some usability in your human action, in your social action exactly. That define the meaning of the life exactly. Now, human values. We will study different human value. What is it exactly? We will study in this brief what is value today itself, but we will study in a very elaborated manner in the later class, because this is also subtopics in your human lesson from the life, teaching of the great readers, reformers, human values, role of the family to inculcate in this value, society, education, institution inculcating values. So I'm giving you the example of socialization. Socialization means what? You are learning this norms and values of the society through your upbringing exactly. The moment, the first unit of this socialization, the moment you born in your family are your. For example, you're involved in this play stage. I was giving you example, this play stage. The moment you are in your home, okay, you're not going to schools. Here, multiple institutions are involved in it. Till now, what is you having? You are in the home. You are being socialized by your parents or your close relatives. How? Through many of these games or plays you're involved in. For example, how this women are exactly treat matter, or they have to dress like this, or they have to do. For example, many this time, this girl's child used to play this Barbie doll. they have been inculcated through this, ki you are the woman, you have to behave in a certain way, and that is being taught by the society through socialization process. Okay, you are the boys, you are giving these guns, but when this, okay, the girl's child born, they are giving dolls, many of this. Exactly, this is what, now you are the, like boys, you have given gun, you have become this, your role is also defined in this manner. So exactly what is getting, this is all about the socialization impact. Okay, so we'll study this depths, what is it all about. So this is the very first unit, we will study in it. Next, unit 2, attitude. Normally we consider attitude, what attitude hai tere ko? Kuch dar se nikal ke bhai, attitude mein rahiye. This is the thing exactly we see, and this normally we interchangeably use many of the things which we really have a very vague idea of things. Attitude is something of related to ego. But this is not the ego, and attitude is not the same thing. These both are different. So we'll study the attitude. Attitude, it means the permanent, this is a permanent character or permanent part of your habit. The habit which becomes permanent in nature, it becomes the attitude. Exactly, and this habit is also developed on this basis of what? Certain ideas were, and it concretized recently into this habit. Habit becomes attitude, and further this habit becomes ideology. This is a chain of things. Okay, we will study this attitude. Content, what is this exactly? Structure kya hoga? Kitne tarah ke attitude hote hain? And what it function exactly play? Okay, now it influences the behavior, thought process. The attitude of a particular person, attitude of everybody. In fact, it is a very famous saying, the attitude defines your success. I'm giving the very good example. The example of Sachin and Kambli. Okay, what makes the difference in fact? Sachin is like the god. He was the Bharat Ratna awardee. And Vinod Kambli, you know, he rose for prominence for a very specific point of time. 2 years he was on the central stage. After that, nobody knows who was the Vinod Kambli. And the Sachin reached to the stage where he accorded the status of Bhagwan almost. The Bhagwan of cricket, we really accord this symbol to that person. Okay, what is the difference between the attitude? Sachin was having this attitude even at this age of 30 or 35. He used to play like a child. He used to practice like a child. And that Vinod Kambli was having this attitude of very flamboyant. Gale ka bachcha stola. Materialistic kind of attitude toward this game. And because of this, he is out of this game. So, this attitude defined many of your success in this examination. Or also for your preparation. Attitude matters. Your attitude towards your preparation, attitude towards priority matters. We think it's like a 1-2 day affair. Come on, theek aajkal lete hain, we do it like, come on, kal se waise karenge. And gradually, slowly, this habit becomes your attitude, and you don't know ki when you are out of this examination. Okay, and it'll become this pass of the obsolete stock of your this. Okay, so you have to, attitude matters. Guys. So we'll all study this attitudinal aspect in this. Getting my point? Now, moral and political attitude, what is the difference? Social influences and persuasion. How this attitude is defined and how your attitude will define this social process. This is a two-way, in fact. The way, this one perspective is like what? It's mainly, you learn a lot from the society. Society is like a what? A building block or the solid block, which is what? Which teaches you lots of things. But individual also through his attitude, through his action, also changes the societies. In fact, the whole attitude of the society changes because of one person. Many of the time in Hindi, just say, akela chana bhaad nahi phodta. Okay, but many of this time, akele chale ne aisa bhaad phoda ki, this whole generation has become. For example, Marx. For example, Bhagat Singh. For example, Gandhi. For example, many of these peoples really have changed the attitude towards life. Exactly what you used to think and what they have offered you, they have really changed a lot. Also studies many of these thinkers in it. Exactly. Unit 3, aptitude. Attitude and aptitude, what's the differences between them? Attitude is your permanent character of your habit. Aptitude is a certain skills which you need to perform certain work. For example, I have this aptitude to teach you, but my attitude is being friendly with you. You're not getting me, what is the difference between them? Okay? No, connected and I stay tuned. Bhatakna nahi hai mere bhai log, theek hai na? Okay. Aptitude. So integrity, impartiality, non-partiality, this all we will study in this unit. Unit 3. The unit 4 comes this emotional intelligence, which is called EI or EQ mostly prefer. Okay, and now in a modern time, when this, because of this, especially in this postmodern world, exactly where this, in this modern world, everything considered with this modernism is good. What is this? Anything or any changes coming through this modernization is good or functional, exactly. Okay, but is this postmodern world exactly? We really also question this modernization aspect. It really have brought some positive change. It also has many of this negative change also. Earlier in my earlier classes, I have discussed what? Development and displacement. Modernization has led many of this wiping out of the small and skill industry, indigenous knowledge, traditional knowledge. So modernization is also has a critique. So this modernization growth world really is to be focused on IQ, intelligence quotient. Okay, your memory power, exactly. Okay, now this is more on this EQ part. This puts, this is what they think human is like, all self-capable. Whatever you have the capabilities, this is same to your success, exactly. But here this meaning of the success different in this case of EQ. Okay, this is not now, all others are also involved in this process. You are not the alone, the society is also involved. For the job you are going for this, okay, you are not the sole like by bap of this whole exam, okay, this whole setup. You have to work in parallel with or in hand of all these people, exactly. And for that purpose, you have to manage emotional regulation. Emotional regulation is very much. You should be calm and composed during your duty. In fact, when you are offering your duty, you have to be, for example, any communal right has happened. Okay, and you are the DM, your identity belongs to the identity of the main writer group. In that case, you have a dilemma, ethical dilemma, which you call it. You have to manage emotionally how you have to respond to this situation. If you are very much emotional to your identity, to your community, things will become very much tricky in that case. Exactly. And also that situation can put you in a trouble also. Okay, so you have to be that much street smart girl. So IAS is not a job for the nerds, the bookmongers. It's a very practical one. Okay, those who are very practical, they will be like good civil servants. This is ranking us for the initial year success. Okay, that is really important. What is EQ? So we'll study this, what is EQ in elaborated manner, this, all this component, what it offers exactly, and what is the consequence of overall EQ, how it will happen exactly. Now, fourth, emotional concept, their utilities, application and administration, how will apply EQ in this part. Okay, unit 5, contribution of moral thinkers and the philosopher from India and the world. In the fifth unit, we will study it. Exactly. For example, we will study many of this Kant, Rawls, Gandhi, okay, Ambedkar, and what are their contribution, especially to establish ethics of a certain kind. For example, we are discussing what ethics, ethics of Ambedkar is what, rule of law. Okay, ethics is what, scientific temper, Nehru. Okay, Gandhi, Ahimsa, these all are ethics they have set up for this. So we will study and their contribution, what they have contributed in this overall. And this one is a practical, is therefore applicable. When you're writing this answer while giving this, we'll do this value mapping and we'll still apply this, okay, the theory of this philosopher or thinker into this. Exactly. So we'll study it. Unit 6, public service values and ethics in a public institution. How specifically this public service values exactly is all about? Exactly, what value as a public servant you have to possess, and what are this civil services value you should be having? But before, what I'm saying, just before independence, when this colonial hangover was there, in fact after this, what is happening, the value of our bureaucrats or this Indian civil servant was very antagonistic type. They were averse to this downtrodden. Exactly, they were only mean to enjoy their life. They are like a mai bap. Okay, but such value is not going to help them in this deliverance of their duty in this modern time. That's why UPSC has put this paper into this. You need to change your value. Okay, the certain ethical or certain civil service value you have to inculcate. For example, during this British time, what was the value this Indian civil service used to possess, or this whole bureaucracy? They used to be secretive in nature. Okay, official secret. Many of these things was not made to the public because the nature of this overall state or administration was very much fishy. They used to extract only this wealth. Now everything should be transparent. This whole process, the people should be incorporated in the administration of the country. That is the example of bottom to top approach. It means participation of the people. Earlier used to be like armchair, in fact, sociologists are armchair policy maker. You are sitting at the table, you are making plan of the whole of the district. And you don't know, okay, what is the real requirement of that particular, in fact, the sub region or in your district exactly. Now you should be the participative unit. That will give the legitimacy to your work also. Okay, you should be transparent. You should be responsive to the public. Okay, well, let's study all this. Now, so ethical concern, the dilemma in a government or this private is fail, laws, rules, regulation, conscience, accountability. In fact, we also studies many of this commission of the Farthen Committee, Nolan Committee, second ARC and all this, what they have suggested for this, what value they have offered you, what value they have, they want you to teach exactly. So they will all study in this unit. Unit 7, probity in government. Okay, because everything is all governance real, in which almost it covers almost each and everything. Because state is everywhere. All these things, how this country is being, this is all architecture through which is being, this is all your governance model. Governance. A governance should be what? The key, good governance. Okay, we are not only the governance, only for the good governance. Here also we will study this, what? The information technology reform in this, e-governance which you call it. Now how it has made things life simple, in fact, in the delivery of this essential services to the public, how does it improve by this e-governance? We will study in this exactly. So probity unit, case study and our basic. Okay, we have still case study, there will be certain dilemma. So these are the brief of this. It seems very much short, but there are much layer involved in it. So we'll study each by each in a chronological manner, in a sequential manner. Okay, so now guys, start with the today lecture. First of all, what is ethics? So I have given you much of this puzzled statement, the mixed interchangeable statement. So what is ethics exactly? You tell me. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, Neha, Fauzia, Tarannum. They have like, okay, guys, stay tuned with me. I'm on this. Okay, the flight has onboarded. So now, what is ethics, guys? You tell me, what is ethics? You know, you should be having... This is the kind of behavior we are saying. Humans take behavior and actions. Exactly. Any other answers? Behavior and doing the? Inculcating the right thing. Inculcating the right thing. Exactly. You have given this answer. Okay. Now, anybody from this back bench? You tell me, guys.
Set of principles or way of living which has a moral, within a moral boundaries.
Within a moral boundary. Which is acceptable within a
common flow of the society.
Okay. You are just, I want some crisp answer. You are just like beating around the bush. Okay. You are giving this some dimension of this ethics. This is all comprised. What you have told me, what you told me, what you call our ethics. I'm not denying this fact. So don't go, just go outside. Yeah, sir, ko to aate nahi, mera pata hai to aate. Theek hai. What is? Huh, definitely these are the principles which guide the human action. And this is like, so this very first definition, I'm just like, you kind of make you write exactly, write it down. Ethics is a systematic study, right? Ethics is a systematic study of human action. From the point of view, okay, ethics is a systematic study of human action from the point of view of their rightfulness and wrongfulness. As a means for attainment of ultimate happiness. Should I repeat? Ethics is a systematic study of human action from the point of view of their rightfulness and wrongfulness as means for attainment of ultimate happiness. This is the first definition I have given. And for, again, before discussion, this ethics word exactly had come from this word, Greek word ethos. Okay. This means habit, character. Okay. Greek word. It has originated from giveaways. All this ethics and all this terminology is used in a Greek or Latin. So why is the logic behind this? Why we all these terminologies or medical terminologies or this terminology related to any of this respective discipline, psychology, sociology, any of this, what you call this, all this logic. They are in Greek or Latin. What is the reason behind why they are not in Hindi or English or this in French or Chinese? This is a very much in the pertinent question. I'm not asking any bullshit, right? Come on, you tell me. What is the logic behind this? Colonialism. But Greek were not the colonial. In fact, the Greek, this ancient, they are the ancient language. Okay, this is your giving answer. Come on, this could be one. Everything is documented, their culture. Okay. Two set of answers. Anybody want to try why this everything is in this Latin and Greek? Okay, ancient, it means we were not having any ancient kind of civilization. So they were having this, what, privilege to, in fact, name any of this terminology by their name because they were the most older one. This is not the case, guys. Come on. Anyone? You, ma'am, please, you try. Why? Apply your logic. Why? Because still now we have seen many of these terms in Greek and Latin. So haven't you asked this query should be in your mind ki why this is in Latin and Greek only? Why this is not in another language? Because there are multiple languages in the world. If you will take this, you should take a very primitive language of belongs to some tribal group. Okay, they are much older than the civilization. Paleolithic or something, Chalcolithic, and should be the case. Why but this is Greek and Latin? Why? Come on, you from back benches, you figures like smiling. Why? What is the reason there? Boliye, kuch kuch boliye. I want you to interact with the discussion. Come on. Shouldn't be like a very passive kind of flow of information. I want this like a bilateral. You learn from me and I'll also learn from you. Huh? Is it the case, really? No. Come on, no. This is wrong. This is, guys, come on. This is why, because everything is in Latin and Greek, because of this, what happened in this modern terminology is to bring the uniformity. What happened? It is all modern language which have evolved, which give you the example. For example, Chinese, okay, Sanskrit, or many of this language of it. They have like what? They are still in developing stages. They are developing. Even they are in the development. They have one stop their growth itself. Exactly. For example, every time you can see this Oxford dictionary or this Cambridge dictionary adding some new words or kind of aberration or change into this phonetics every time society is changing, new things coming into this. Pehle cheezon ko kuch aur bole the, now pronouns have been changed. But these languages, Latin and Greek, has stopped this development. They are like now stopped. There is no development. No new word could be added to their dictionary and no could be deleted from their dictionary. There is no evolution process. Their evolution has stopped. So what will happen if you name them by the Latin and Greek? It will remain the same. So you shouldn't be having any confusion. For example, if the Chinese study this ethics, it shouldn't be another thing for the ethics. All are same. That is the reason, because Latin and Greek are used in this. I'm giving some other information also. So what is this? I have made you write what? Systematic study of human action. Okay, from the point of view of its rightfulness and wrongfulness as a means for attainment of ultimate happiness. So this is what ethics is, systematic action of human behavior. Okay, from the point of view of its rightfulness and wrongfulness. It means if you are the human, you should be having a choice. It means something could be right, something could be wrong. And ultimately, why this categorization of right and wrong is there? Why? Because something, it is fulfilling some function exactly. It has some purpose. The purpose is what? Attainment of ultimate happiness. Happiness has not an individual happiness, the societal happiness. It means these all are what? Set of standard that society impose upon you exactly. All set of standard. Okay? Which helps you to guide your behavior, choices or action. But this is very much contextual in nature. But I'm giving you a definition, all set of standards, guidelines which society place upon you. Okay, society has many of this instrument through which it guides your behavior, it controls your behavior, it regulates your behavior. Norms, customs, values, these all are what? these are the instrument through which society regulates behavior. They want you to conform to certain norms. They want you to follow certain customs. They want you to have certain values. They want you to have certain what? All this set of guidelines. Exactly. Or this is very much contextual nature. We will again go into this deeper discussion. Okay? मैं अभी तुम लोग को फिर से कंफ्यूज छोड़ रहा हूं. Okay? Now, again, on this board. Okay? This person, Mackenzie, defines ethics as the study of what is right or good in human conduct or the science of ideal involved in a human life. So, ethics is all about exploration of this ideal. There must be something ideal which you need to stick upon. There must be something overall, a macro goal which you have to conform. For example, honesty. This is a ideal. In the case of political economy, if I say, this is what? Republicanism, socialism, fraternity, brotherhood. This is what? Ideals. And these are all what? Seen in a very positive light. This thing separates good and bad. So, ethics is what? It categorizes your worldview. It categorizes society or this part of your human action into two part. That is what? Something is good, something is desirable. Okay, or something is bad, something is undesirable. Okay, so something is good, which is anything which is good, or anything which is bad. It means the person or the individual will be encouraged to follow this good, and they will be dissuaded or demotivated to not pursue this bad. So this good and bad is referenced to whom? To you or to society as a large. Society as a large, exactly. It means this good, whatever society thinks is good, this is good for you. Many of these cases it can happen. What is good societally or on the societal level, but this couldn't be good at individual level. For example, a society imposes restriction on the intercaste marriage. There are multiple ways to enforce it, but you are a very liberal, you have got your education from very of this good universities from India, you have a certain open liberal value, but you want to pursue the same thing. You got into love with some person who is from the other caste, but your has what? Societal class is there. Society don't want to do the same thing and you want to do. Here is what? Intercaste marriage has been made forbidden. This part bad. Okay. Getting my point, guys? Okay. So this is what ethics is what? This is a categorization. This is a systematic study of the human being from the point of view of its rightfulness and wrongfulness as the means to attain the happiness. Here the happiness is means overall societal happiness. Here happiness means other means solidarity in the society, stability in the society. There should be order in the society. In order to maintain that order, societal order, there are certain things which have been significant as a good and as a bad. And but this notion of good and bad is a very contextual in nature. It means it depends upon the society to society. What is good for the Indian society couldn't be good for a Western society. What is good for a tribal society couldn't be good for a modern society. For example, in many of the societies, they follow this polyandry. That means one woman, multiple husband. But can you imagine this polyandry at today's context, especially in Delhi or in Haryana? One woman, five husband. What will happen in this case? The ethics has changed now. The same ethics, what they were, polyandry was acceptable in tribal society. But this polyandry has become this bad aspect of the society. It means you need not to follow this. So this is contextual. Now, for example, again, I'm giving the example of this. This is contextual how? Individualism. It means to pursue your individual aspiration. It means, another word, if I put it, what is this? This is further accumulation of private wealth. You can attain section by accumulation of wealth, income generation. For that purpose, you acquire all this skill, education, Okay, and for that person, individual in nature, individualism, they are, the individual right is being very much honored in that particular individual. For example, societies like US, Western society, they focus more on this individual aspect. But this modern, this ancient civilization, for example, India, the Greece, these are this Mesopotamia, these are the what? They focus more on this socialist aspect. Where the society is supreme, individual is not. But the societal interest is larger than individual interest. So here is what, again, two society, two goals, two ethical guidelines exactly, the where the one is individualism followed, but in the case is, this follows exactly. So this is what, ethics is very much contextual nature. So it couldn't be universal. It means it is present in all the society, but this forms and degree were vary. This is very much contextual. Ethics is contextual. What is good for you couldn't be good for me. Getting my point? There are multiple examples of it, which you can say, for example, in many of this, for example, in this country, Western country, single mother, being a single mother is, couldn't be considered as a taboo. But in Indian society, if your locality have such elements, what will happen then? That person or that lady will face discrimination in this whole locality. So this is what? Different set of standard. But this different set of standard has been set up according to this context, because every tradition, let me tell you, every tradition or every this custom has its background of origin. The society is a kind of, this is the all this custom is situated, they are sui generis in nature, they have evolved by automatically because of this background. For example, once sati was there, it was prevalent, now it is not. Once child marriage were there, this was a prevalent norm, people used to follow this exactly. But now child marriage, in fact almost in all the corner, in all walk of life, they are considered as a bad, though it is also prevalent in Indian society exactly. So this is very much contextual in nature. Getting my point? So again, now come to the next slide. Some definition again. This person, Albert Camus, says, a man without ethics is a wild beast loose upon this world. A man without ethics is a wild beast loose upon this world. This is the benefit, or what you will say, consequence of the ethics exactly, that person by his definition is trying to teach you. Why ethics is important? Without ethics, a person or a human will become a beast. That will person will create a ruckus in the society. Okay, the society, the whole of the order will be derailed. Exactly, here this person has become what? Rebel, a kind of what? Rebel it has become. Okay, it has become deviant, another name of this. Okay, and the deviance activity ultimately create problem in the society overall. So this is what ethics is. What ethics? All sort of this norms, values, attitude, everything you inculcate being as a member of that particular community of the society through the process of socialization. Okay, and through this ethics, this norms and value wants you to behave in a certain manner. Okay, so the ethics has a very large area to cover, in fact. Getting my point? So all things, that's why it has been interchangeably used, ethics, norms, everything. Because ethics is incorporates each and everything of this. Now we'll also study this ethics in a more in the deeper form. Again, Henry Paulson. In just about every area of the society, there is nothing more important than the civilization overall. This ethics, this society, you are the part of the society, you are living in it. You should have to follow certain rules, because how this order will be created? There must be some order, there must be some common values, or there must be something which should be shared by everyone. For example, now take the case of Indian modern time, Indian Constitution. Indian Constitution is what? This is a minimal, in fact, this is a book, law book exactly, which defines the character of India, political character, social character, economic character. This is a law of the land. Exactly. So this Constitution of India is what? This is a minimal agreement where the citizen and government has come together to at least on agreement, on this minimal agreement, you have to do this much of, I have to do this much. Because in society, everyone has a competing goal. He wants to aspire something that could be in conflicting with that person. For example, this lady wants to enjoy his fundamental right, her. Exactly. She wants to what? Play the very loud music in his house party. But that is problematic for the neighbor. It is her right, exactly. Who can stop her? But at the same time, while enjoying her right, she is trying to intervene in your right, exactly. So now it's a clash. You want to be a billionaire by whatever means you are following. You're not here with this means. But for the success, for me, is this material advancement. For that purpose, you are resorting to all those illegal activities. You are going to smuggling, you are going to, in fact, killing of something also. You are into this blood diamond or this, all this business you are. You are the mafia of this. But in this course of action, what has happened? Your means or your goals has in conflicting with others, that person. Okay, you kill the brother of this person because both have. So what is this? In fact, if this goes, what will happen? There will be chaos in the society. There will be anarchy. There will be something. No? There must be some central authority which guides your behavior. And for that purpose, there is something necessary to set a guidelines for everybody so to be followed. This is a shared one, exactly. You are agreed on this minimal condition. I am agreed on this minimal condition. Then society will come forward. Then society will become fucked. Otherwise, everybody think, jiski lathi, uski bhans. Survival of the fittest. What is the rule of the jungle? Survival of the fittest. Jisko jitni taakat hai, wo sabse zyada powerful. Those who have all the resources, they are most powerful, they are being worshipped. But you can't imagine in the human society. If the things is like that, things will be in chaos. How? Because you all are, for example, you all are like what? Good at some stance, but you will be having some kind of vulnerability and many of these stance also. Human cannot be perfect. So human knew this, ki I alone, I cannot do all the things. I need this cooperation in order to make this flow, to continue this civilization. For that purpose, you need to bring what? An ethical code, a set of standard which everybody should follow. Otherwise, this won't work exactly. So this is the overpass. You are getting my guys? Clarity. अभी ethics की तुमने भी sorting clarity हो जाएगी. बकवास करोगे तुम तो class में. ठीक है. Now, a state of standard, what a place of society. Okay. It's simple. But ethics refers to what is good and way to get and what is bad and how to avoid. Exactly. All those of instrument, all those of things which is good and which is bad. This is categorization of which is moral and which is immoral. Which is good and which is bad. Which is rightful and which is wrongful, and all those things which lead to this path, rightful and wrongful, is all this, the societal, all this pressure, all this control is a part of what? This, all this structure is a part of ethics. At a structure level, this is what? Ethics. Na? Samajh rahe ho, achhi baat hai. Nahi samajhne ke baad bahut dikkat. Now, I'll discuss the scope of ethics. We have studied, also have like what? Chalked out or draw a boundary of bit of a vague boundary of ethics. Okay, now again the scope ethics, from where or till what boundary ethics rest, or what ethics is, what is the boundary of the ethics exactly, we will study in this scope. Because human as a actor or human as an individual in the society has multiple function to perform. Some are deliberate in nature, some are what, voluntary in nature or non-voluntary in nature, which you do as your daily routine, which is necessary, which is your DNA, which you are need to do. Exactly. So there are two parts of the human action. Okay, this action. This is what is in divided into. We can distinguish between a human action and the action of human. There is a difference between this. Human action and action on the. And ethics, we deal only with human action. So guys, you tell me, what is the difference between this human action and action of the human?
Human action has some human values or morals. Action of human be anything. It doesn't have anything. Not necessary to have any moral values, or not necessary to have some genuine quality or something.
Chalo, something, I mean, you are reaching to this, but again, you are...
Human actions, and when it is a inherent behavior from inside from this particular human.
Okay.
Actions of humans. Okay.
So still by yourself, what were in your mind? Don't look at board. I'll teach you. Okay, you just say your what your common sense is saying about this.
What is the difference between human action and action in human?
No idea. Aap bataiye ma'am. Kya bata rahi thi?
Sir, action of human means any action that we take. It could be voluntary,
involuntary action like sleeping, walking. Yes, exactly. This is action of the human. This difference between this human action and action of a human, this action, human action, those actions done by deliberately. Okay, in the view of achieving some end. It means a deliberate action, this human action incorporate all those actions which you do deliberately in order to achieve a end. There's sometimes some purpose behind this. You calculate this in your mind. Exactly. There are multiple. For example, you want to become an IAS officer. For that purpose, you just say, okay, this is a dream, I have to become an IAS officer, okay? And I'll fulfill all my this obligation, in fact. Okay, all this my neighbor will help once. Now they're criticizing me. Now I'll raise my hand, head of my families also, okay? This is the notion behind it. For that purpose, what you are doing deliberately, you just searched on the Google, which is the best coaching. What is the scheme of the examination, okay? And by through this, you went to Delhi. You came to Karol Bagh. Okay, and you got an admission, the best of you made your choice, whatever choice you made, depend upon this situation. It's not like something is, oh, achi coaching hai, buri coaching, all the same. They all have made you all are rational being. The words of Adam Smith, I've said, you all are the rational being. Whatever action you are taking, that is what the reflection of your socio-economic background and your overall rational choices. This is all you have made rational choices. Okay. घर पे जाके ऐसे नहीं रोना है कि अरे यार आईएस आ गया तो क्या बुरा तो नहीं कर दिया, लेकिन ये कोचिंग आके तो बर्बाद नहीं हो गए. आई शुड गो टू सम अदर कोचिंग. सो दिस इज थिंग यू हैव मेड ऑल अ रैशनल चॉइस. सो ऑल दिस डेलिबरेट एक्शन यू शुड टेक इन ऑर्डर टू अचीव समथिंग इन रिटर्न. एग्जैक्टली, दिस ऑल अ डेलिबरेट एक्शन. और दिस एक्शन ऑफ द ह्यूमन इज व्हाट? दिस आर द एक्शन व्हिच इज डन अननोइंगली, व्हिच इज अनडेलिबरेट इन नेचर. एग्जैक्टली. ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, मेनी ऑफ दिस एक्टिविटी यू परफॉर्म, यू वॉक, to eat, many of this biological function to perform, to sustain yourself, you have to do it, you have to sleep. This is another thing you have decided to have to sleep. But this is what? These are the actions which you do individually, which nobody's involved in exactly. This you want, and this human action here, others seem involved. This is more of the societal in nature, human action. Where you anticipate any work, or this any work exactly involves some other person also. You are coming to the coaching, you also calculate many of this in your mind. I'll go to this, some person would be there, okay, my colleague would be there, like my classmate would be there, I'll have to behave in such a manner. You have all this calculated in your mind before coming to this coaching. Exactly. But this individual, this action of the human walking, just like doing this walking, I'm not thinking of anything. So this is of what? Action of him. So this, for this ethics paper, exactly, we have to deal with this human action, which is more of this reflection of. Okay, so we will deal with the human action, not this action of the human. So don't say again, I was coming, sir, certain person was walking in my corridor, he was my neighbor, but he was doing this, he was walking in a very, very absurd way. He was like dancing in this whole floor. But this is not a societal ethics, exactly. You should behave in this particular manner. Exactly. So such thing is not the part of this ethics. Getting my point? This is the scope of ethics. We have to deal with human action, not action of the human. Got it? Here, what is the difference between this? Intention. What makes the differences? Intention of the individual, which makes the differences exactly. The differentiation between human action and action of the human. Here, intention makes the differences. Getting my point? Clear? Good. Hum log kab tak class hoti hai? 6:50. बोलते ना कि अगर यूपीएससी की तैयारी करनी, यू शुड नोइंग कि व्हाट शुडंट आई स्टडी. Why should I not read it? So the same is the ethics. If you have to understand the ethics, so you have to understand which ethics is not exactly. Okay, so I'm making comparison with ethics and morality. Because we have discussed a lot about this morality, because this rightfulness or the good and the part is at moral level. This is what morality, and then in this sense, morality and ethics are the same, it looks same. And what is the difference between ethics and morality? Please.
For me,
yes.
Society says we have to come home at around 10. All the girls have to be home at 10. While my brother is waking and partying out.
Okay.
But for me, I also believe morally that I should be having backward and photo.
I'm getting you. Okay. You are right in fact. Okay, this is more of individual. Any other person or any other answers from any of this corner? You man. But what is this difference between ethics and morality? Bataiye. He said right in fact. Morality. Is it that part of ethics? Or would you say what is the difference between ethics and morality? Morality is more of this individual in nature. Okay, this is more of society is more of this societal standard. For society, this is more of external in nature ethics. Okay, externally, society has prescribed certain norms, values, customs, which you have to prescribe, which you need to follow. But this morality, many of these times, for example, something is ethical in the society but couldn't be moral for you. For example, I take the example of many of this. For example, in any of the society, for example, I take the example of Kha Panchayat. In that particular, I'm referring to a society example. This is academic decision, so don't take it personal. Exactly. Anything here is like academic decision, so don't sue me in the court also. Okay. So this is what, in that particular society, what is this? Kha Panchayat, this is what? A kind of intercaste marriage, there is a ban on this. This is a prohibited. And this is what? The norms the society has placed upon this. You can't do enter into this, any of this agreement or any of this bondage where this opposite sex belong to two different castes. This is an ethical one. But at moral level, as you have studied, you are like rational being, you have studied from DU or JNU. What do you have this develop as? Very liberal attitude. You have this what? At moral level, you don't want to conform to this inter-ban on inter-caste. This is your level of morality. Morality is very much individual in nature. What you consider exactly? Many of these times, law conform to this, but your morality doesn't allow to do this. Exactly. Many of this side, society prescribe ki this, you can do this, but you say, can't morally, I can't do this. What famous movie hai wo Sultan Mirza wala, have you seen this? The famous character of Ajay Devgan, B Company, I think name of this movie. So bolta hai wo, that person who is actor bolta hai ki main us cheez, matlab he was a smuggler, okay, was in which he says exactly main wo cheeze karta hu jo sarkar ya fir main wo cheeze main allow karta jiski zameer ijazat deta hai, na ki jiski sarkar hai. To government here is saying that government has put ban on many of this smuggling, but many of the time he was given this order or the consignment of this drug smuggling. So he says after that ki I don't do such types of things because such actions is not allowed, or fir this is not sent by my conscience to perform exactly to a drug dealing. I do all kinds of illegal activity which government has banned on it. So that purpose he says. So this is what morality is more of this individual in nature exactly. We'll study more on this. There's a term I'm writing in this. Okay. Acquiescence. Okay. Acquiescence. Okay. So this ethics demand acquiescence from others. What ethics? Ethics demand acquiescence from others. But this morality. Doesn't demand this acquiescence from others. What is this meaning of this acquiescence?
Binding?
Legally.
Legitimate.
Approval.
approval kind of thing exactly. Acquiescence is this. Society wants to follow to this, even though you are not, even though you are not agree with that. This is like a more of forceful. You have to follow it. Exactly. But this morality says there's no pressure on the individual. If you want to follow, you don't want to follow exactly. There is no, for example, any of the things, for example, society wants to do exactly. But here there is no force at all. You don't need to follow this acquiescence. Even though you are not agreeing to that particular principle, don't agree. That is cool with you. So this is a part of what? Morality or ethics. So morality more of this individual in nature. Getting my point? Or morality samajh mein aa raha hai? Any of this doubt? No doubt. Now I'll reach to this again. Ethics and religion. In fact, with this classes, as a class will proceed further, the clarity will further embolden. So, ek din mein hum Buddha nahi ban jayenge. It will take time. Okay? Getting my point? Up to you. Oh, I have to give example of certain topics. I have given you the source of this example. Things should be bookmarked in your mind. From now onwards, you have to document in exactly. You have to see all these quiz studies, all this happening in the surrounding, all this in newspaper, everywhere. You get something out, but how you will get it something which is usable for you for this paper? For that purpose, syllabus should be in your mind. If this is blinking every time in your mind, the syllabus, the topics, you will automatically will, that will be exactly inked in your mind. This is this normal process. This is a very much, you don't need to was very much, very lengthy diary making kind of thing. No, you don't need to do this exactly. Okay, just you have to like, syllabus should be clear. So integrity, for example, integrity is clear you. So if you see this newspaper and you find this example, if any of the civil service has compromised this integrity aspect, you just click this. This is integrity. You just made a small note that person was what, compromising with the integrity. Getting my point? You saw any of this example of EQ, where that person has shown or exhibited a very much example of emotional quotient, a presence of mind. Exactly. You just kept it. So this is like a, get it from newspaper, from any other source. For UPSC, you can, source could be anything. Okay, but your mind should be alert and aware all the time. For that purpose, UPSC should be your priority. Keep in mind, you are eating, walking, anything you're doing, one should always blink your mind. And thus blinking shouldn't stop for a longer period of time. Okay, you can make fun in mid-print, but that's blinking. That's bookmarking should continue. You should be having all the time, you should be reminding yourself, you are into this examination. And this is what training purpose. You know, this whole examination is a training exactly. You are being into inculcated, these values you are learning in here exactly. What you are supposed to do, what are all the things which happens practically, all are related every time. And this is very much discussed because it covers almost every walk of your life. So you have lots of things to discuss about. At the chai ki tapri, and so instead of discussing bakwas, bullshit, you can incorporate many of this productive discussion. Okay, this is very much handy and healthy also. In fact, you can make your micro group also in the class. Okay, for example, you wrote something on this answer writing and you are discussing among yourself. This is morality, this is religion, you have written. So this really increases a lot, in fact. This is a lot of value addition. Self-study, there is no, the substitute of this exercise. Okay, and this is a synthesis approach also. What is this synthesis approach in this examination? Yeah? Synthesis. This is what 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. But the synthesis approach makes is 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. It means if you put all your effort exactly together simultaneously, the outcome of the result greater than the input you have put in exactly. Okay, so here this law of diminishing marginality or the disguised employment won't happen exactly. Now you will get more kind of outcome. For example, for this whole purpose, what you study, for example, you're studying current affairs. Okay, so what you do? One of the person who's economic civil, that person prepare that section. Okay, for example, who's in environment ecology good, you prepare that person and you make a discussion out of it. You make it understand, you make it understand. So this is a what? Synthesis approach. Okay, getting more from this? what do you put as effort? Now guys, come on. So ethics and religion. So what is religion? What is ethics? Many of these times, religion is also the source of ethics. Religion specifies many of the set standard or the custom which you need to follow exactly. For example, you are the non-vegetarian, or you are the vegetarian person exactly. Your religion say you have to be vegan. For example, you are from the Jain community. Okay, in that case, this vegetarianism is also a ethics for you. So these all are interchangeably used. There's a lots of, what you will say, overlapping of this subject, norms, ethics, values, all are. But you have to just catch up one chore, isko bolte. Ek chore pakad ke chalna hai. So you have to see this distinction, what I'm giving you as a definition. Okay, otherwise lots of jargons and lots of interchangeable words are used. You'll become confused. You just have to go to distinction. What is the difference between them? Okay, that will make clear. I'll make it clear, guys. Okay, don't be confused. So this is what ethics versus religion. What given you, ethics is all about set standard or the guidelines or prescribed manner which you need to conform to this exactly. Religion is, for example, religion hai kya? What is this religion?
Norms.
This could be, if in this sense, if I go by this sense, the communism, it could also be a kind of religion also. Communism, they have a different walk of life, they have different set of this, they don't have this notion of God, and also this could be the religion also. Then what is this religion? What? Okay, this worship deities and again, spirituality and difference between spirituality and religion. You have to be over this preparation. Yes, you need to be more specific. Everything is different from anything. This perspective will help you exactly. So this spirituality and religiosity is two different things exactly. Religiosity is different from religion is all sort of customs, rituals, okay, which is surrounding around a object. This is called a sacred thing. It means all these rituals, all these beliefs, all these customs, okay, in relation with a sacred object. And this object, who defines this? Society. This sacredness aspect, this characteristics of sacred. For example, if I put this is a sacred thing, this overall object is a sacred thing in itself. It has anything to be called as a sacred. For example, in our society, we worship cow. Don't go it otherwise. I'm a Muslim, I'm teaching cows. You'll take like, sir, assembly bol sakte. I respect everyone believes in fact. Okay. For example, if you consider cow as a mother, as a deity, as a god. Rationally, you have to tell me is anything with this cow which is related with this supernatural thing, because religion or the god is phenomena which has some power, which has an influence on anything. The sacred aspect has put by whom? The society. For example, you worship a tree. Does this tree have any of this supernatural element in this, which we'll call it is like this sacred aspect. So religion is what? All those of rituals, all those of customs, all those of tradition relative to this sacred aspect. It means the society divides between sacred part and mundane part, or the sacred or profane part exactly, which is forbidden part, the daily life exactly, and everything that is related with this sacred ritual, everything that is. Again, religion and ethics has overlapping areas. Religion, yes.
They don't have any sacred.
Many of the sacred, don't you think many of the symbolism is there? You don't, I mean, like sacred things in Sanatana Dharma. You don't know. Many of the time, for example, in Islam. Example, listen. For example, in Islam or the Christianity, for example, there is, and they don't have this concept of worshipping demigods, or this concept of the god, or you are just like worshipping an idol. Okay, so they didn't have this conception of this, but the symbolism is also there.
something is considered sacred in Islam. Many of them, for example, moon. In the flag of Pakistan, you have seen the image of Kaaba. This is what? Object, huh? You worship this, every society, all this, this religion is what? The thing surrounding this, sacred. So ethics, religion, many of this time, this religion exactly, what signifies? Religion, many of the time, religion says many of these things, which could be against these ethical values. You cite me in an example, kuch example. For example, many of these times, many peoples are not religious, but they could be ethical. For example, you could be typical, but at the same time, you can't be religious. I'm not a religious person. I have nothing to do with the God and this sacred object. But at the same time, I could be ethical. Okay, I am following all those civic norms. I'm not trying to disturb my neighbors. Okay, I try to do all sort of things which I'm supposed to do as a responsible citizen of India. In that case, I'm following all those laws, regulation, everything. I should respect elder. I'm respecting it. Again, this is another thing, okay? Police interrupt party, not Jagrata, because it has a real force. In this time, especially if this police come into Jagrata, police will go without anything. It will be looted. So you can't do this, like, okay? So this is a different thing, okay? You are merging different thing into this. Okay, I'm telling you what? Religious. For example, any of this person, for example, you are very much religious, but at the same time, you are not ethical. Don't you think all these religious people are good only? Many of this fanatism, religious fanatisms come, they are very much religious. You can see this religious. Okay, you have many of these terrorists or many associated with this particular, or many of this religious bond, terrorist activities happening. Almost all this is not associated only with this particular community. You associated with this terrorism, associated with this particular. You can see in the example of Myanmar, where the certain, okay, they are mainly considered as very peaceful. This religion is very peace loving. They are this concept. I mean, sir, but that person in the name of religion have killed something. So at the center, you become religious, but you can't be ethical. You can be ethical, but you can't be religious. So this religiosity and this ethics has different things. Okay, you can be religious, you can be ethical also, but at the same time, you can't be what? You can't be religious also, but you are ethical. You can be ethical. You are conforming all those set value of the standard, because this ethics is what? This is amalgamation, incorporation of all those set standard guidelines. All this comes into this ethics, and religion is also source of the ethics also. Okay, this has overlapping part, but you have to see this. Okay, thank you.